Hi, my dear students. Hope you all are safe. Dear students, in our last class science, we discussed about crop production and management, right? Different practices we learned. What all are they? That is preparation of soil and tools using for the preparation of soil. Did you remember that one? Okay, very good. So now I am going to teach you about another practices we are using in agricultural purposes. That is, in this class we are discussing about sowing and adding fertilizers and manures. Okay, adding fertilizers and manures. These two practices we are going to learn now. Okay, so children, what is sowing? What is sowing, children? Sowing means it is the process of placing the seeds in soil for making a plant, right? For growing a plant. That is we call sowing process, okay? And that also we call planting, okay? And how we have to select the seeds, children? We know that it is a placing the seeds. How we have to select the seeds? Is it good or bad, or is it healthy or unhealthy seed? How we can select? This selection we can check through one activity. So students, we can do one activity now. That is separating good seeds from damaged one. For that one, we have to need water filled with a pan. Okay, take a beaker and fill half of water. Then put a handful of pea seeds. I am going to put a handful of pea seeds in here. Okay, and we can check how we have to separate good seeds from it. Okay, so put a handful of pea seeds and stir well and wait for some time. We can observe what will happen. You will see some of the seeds start floating on the water, right? Okay, that is damaged seeds become hollow and float. Clear? But good seeds settle down. This is a good method for separating good and healthy seeds from the damaged one. That is healthy and good seeds that is settled down. Damaged seeds that are floating, right? So this is a good method. All should have to do this activity in your home. Okay, we can see these damaged seeds. Okay, so children, from the experiment we can understand how we have to select the seed. What are the main criteria for selecting the seed, children? Seed should be healthy, right? Then high yield. Then we have to check good quality. Then free from insect and diseases. These are the main criteria for checking the seeds. Okay, so students, before sowing the seeds, let's study about what all are the main tools used for sowing the seeds. That is, we have to use traditional tools and modern tools. Okay, we can check what it is. Okay, traditional tools, we can see in the picture, tools used traditionally for sowing seed. It's shaped like a funnel. The seeds are filled into the funnel and they pass down through two or three pipes having sharp ends. These ends pierce into the soil and place seed there. But in modern tools, sows the seeds uniformly at proper distances and depth. It prevents overcrowding, right? And it ensures that seeds get covered by the soil after sowing. And it also helps to prevent damage caused by birds. And it also helps our save time and labor. So in traditional tools we are using for sowing funnels, right? But in modern tools we are using tractor, and it saves our time and labor also, right? In sowing the seeds also we are using two methods. Look at the picture, you can see direct sowing and transplanting. Good plants we can transplant from that pot, right? So after this sowing we need to add some manures or fertilizers for the growth of the plant. So third method of practices in agriculture we can check. Children, what is manures and fertilizers? It is actually third method of agricultural practices, that is adding manure or fertilizers. Did you heard about that word? I know that you have familiar that words, that is manure and fertilizer. What it is actually? It is a substance which are added to the soil in the form of a nutrients which helps for the growth of healthy plant. That's why we are adding manures and fertilizers. Okay.
Children, just observe this picture. We can easily understand if without manure and fertilizers, what will happen? But when we are adding manures and fertilizers, we can see healthy tomato plant, right?
Children, we can check what all are the main differences between manure and fertilizers. Okay, we know that these both are substances which are added to the soil for a healthy growth of the plant, right? So, what is manure, children? That is, manure is an organic substance. Okay, that is natural substance. But what about fertilizers? Fertilizers are inorganic. Inorganic salt, or we can say like that, it is a chemical substance. Okay, and manure, which is prepared in field. But what about fertilizers? That is prepared in factory. Okay, then manure, which provide lot of humus to the soil. But what about fertilizers? It doesn't provide any humus to the soil. Okay, these are very rich in plant nutrients like sodium, phosphorus and potassium. Comparatively, it is very less nutrients in manure. Okay, so all should have to learn these differences thoroughly. In this class, we discussed about two methods of practices. What are the sowing and adding manure and fertilizers. So all should have to read the chapter thoroughly. Okay, next class, we will discuss about rest of the practices in agriculture. So we can meet in our next class. Thank you.